flores. Flores para los muertos. Flores. Flores para los muertos. Flores.
Blanche.
Oh, Weston, please.
It's me, Mitch.
Mitch, just a moment. Mitch, you know, I really shouldn't let you in after the treatment I've received from you this evening. So utterly uncavalier, but hello, beautiful.
Huh?
And why am I with a cold shoulder? In such uncouth apparel, why you haven't even shaved. But I forgive you because it's such a relief to see you. You stopped that poke tuna hat caught in my head. Have you ever had anything caught in your head? Of course not, you dumb angel puss. You never get anything awful caught in your head.
Do we have to have that fan on?
No.
I don't like fans.
What? I'm not partial to them, honey. Let's turn it off. Oh, I don't know what there is to drink. I haven't investigated.
I don't want Stan's liquor.
It isn't Stan. Some things on the premises are actually mine. How's your mother? Isn't your mother well?
Why?
Well, there's something the matter tonight, but never mind. I won't cross-examine the witness. I'll just pretend I didn't notice anything different about you. That music again.
What music?
The polka tune they were playing when Alan... It always stops after the shop. Anna, it stops.
Are you boxed out of your mind?
Oh, let me see what I can find in the way. By the way, excuse me for not being dressed, but I've practically given you up and you forgot your invitation to
someone. I wasn't going to see you anymore.
I can't hear you, and you talk so little that when you do say something, I don't want to miss a single syllable of it. Oh, I guess I wonder. Seven comfort. What could that be?
You don't know, it must belong to Stanley.
Get your foot off the bed. It has a clean cover on it. Of course, you boys don't notice things like that. I've done so much of the places I've been here.
I bet you have.
Well, you saw it when I came. But now look at it. It's almost dainty looking. I want to keep it that way.
I thought you were leaving pretty soon now, huh?
I wonder if this ought to be mixed with something. It's sweet, so terribly sweet. Why, it's a liqueur, I believe it. That's what it is, a liqueur. I'm afraid you won't like it, but try to make
it. I told you I don't want Stan's liquor, and I mean it. You ought to lay off his liquor. He says you've been lapping it up all summer long like a wildcat.
Oh, what a fantastic statement. Fantastic of him to say it, and fantastic of you to repeat it. But I won't descend to the level of such cheap accusations to answer them, even. What's in your mind? See something in your eyes.
It's dark in here.
I like it dark. The dark is comforting to me.
I don't think I've ever seen you in the light. That's a fact.
Is it?
I don't think I've ever seen you in the afternoon.
Well, whose fault is that?
You never want to go out in the afternoon.
Mitch, you're at the plant.
Not Sunday afternoon, and you never want to go out until after 6 o'clock, and it's always to some place that's not lighted very much.
There's some obscure meaning in all this, but I failed to catch it.
What it means is I've never taken a good look at you, Blanche. I'm turning this light on.
Light? What for?
I spawned with this little paper
thing
on it.
What is that for?
So I can take a look at you good and plain.
Oh, surely you don't mean to be insulting.
No, just realistic.
I don't want realism. I want magic.
Magic?
Yes, magic. I try to give that to people. I do misrepresent things. I don't tell the truth. I tell what ought to be the truth. And if that's a sin, then I'll be damned for it. Don't turn the light on.
I don't mind you being older than what I thought, but all the rest of it, Christ. Christ! That pitch about your ideals being so old-fashioned and that malarkey you've been dishing out all summer long. Oh, I knew you weren't 16 anymore, but I was a fool enough to believe you were straight.
Who told you I wasn't straight? My loving brother-in-law, you believed him?
No, I called him a liar first, but then I checked my stories. First, I asked the supply man that travels through the door, and then I talked directly long distance to this merchant.
Who is this merchant?
Keyfobber.
The merchant Keyfobber of Laurel. I know the man. He whistled at me, so I put him in his place, and now for revenge, he makes up stories.
Free
about
people! Keyfobber scared and sauce!
Oh, no, no, free men in a tub, in such a filthy tub!
Didn't you stay at a hotel called the Flamingo?
Flamingo? No. Tarantula was the name of it. I stayed at a hotel called the Tarantula Arms.
Tarantula Arms?
Yes, the big spider. That's where I brought my victims. Oh, yes, I had many intimacies with strangers. After the death of Alan, intimacies with strangers was all I seemed able to fill my empty heart with. I think it was panic, just panic, that drove me from one to the other, searching for some protection. Even in the most unlikely places. Finally, at last, in a 17-year-old boy, but somebody wrote the superintendent about it. This woman is morally unfit for her position. True? Yes, unfit somehow, I suppose. So I came here. There was nowhere else I could go. I was played out. Do you know what played out is? My youth was suddenly gone up the water spout. And then I met you. Now thank God for you, because you seem to be gentle.
Glorious.
A rock in the world that I could hide in. But I guess I was asking, hoping for too much.
Glorious.
Keep out of Stanley and Shaw tied an old tin can to the tail of the kite.
Glorious. You lied to me, Blanche.
Don't say I lied to you.
Lies, lies, inside and out, it was all
inside,
lies.
Inside, I didn't lie in my heart. I was true as God to all of you, always.
Lourdes.
Always.
Lourdes.
Someone at the
door. Lourdes. No. Lourdes,
Padre Los Muertos. No, not now, not now.
Lourdes, Padre Los Muertos.
I lived in a house where dying old women remembered their dead men.
Lourdes para los muertos.
Crumble and fade. Regrets. Recriminations.
Coronas.
If I hadn't done this, it wouldn't have cost you that. Legacies.
Coronas para los muertos.
And other things too, such as bloodstained pillow slips. Her linen needs
coronas.
Changing. Yes, mother, but couldn't we get a colored girl to do it? Of course not. Everything gone. Everything.
Flores.
Death.
Flores para los muertos.
I used to sit here. And she used to sit over there, and death was as close as you are.
Coronas,
we didn't dare even
muertos.
Admit we never heard of it. Death.
Flores.
And the opposite is desire.
Flores para los muertos.
So do you wonder? How could you possibly wonder? Not far from Belle Reve, before we lost Belle Reve, was a camp where they trained young soldiers. Saturday nights, they'd go into town and get drunk, and then they'd stagger onto my lawn and call Blanche. Blanche. The deaf old lady remaining suspected nothing. But sometimes, I slipped out to answer their calls. Later, the paddy wagon would gather them up like daisies the long way home. What do you want?
I've been missing all summer long.
Then marry me, man.
No, you're not clean enough to put in the house with my mother.
Then go away, then. Get out of here before I start screaming fire. Get out of here before I start screaming fire. Fire! My weary head on your shoulder, so comforting.
Blanche.
How is my sister?
She's doing okay.
And the baby?
Oh, the baby's not gonna come before morning, so they told me to go home and get some shut-eye. Well,
we ought to be alone here?
Yep. Just me and you. What you got those fine feathers on for?
Oh, that's right. You left before my wife came.
You got a wife?
Yes, I received a telegram from an old admirer of mine.
Anything good?
Oh, I think so. An invitation.
What to?
Invited me to a cruise of the Caribbean on a yacht.
Well, what do you know?
And just what I thought, I couldn't be more surprised.
I guess not.
It came like a bolt from the blue.
And who would you say this telegram was from?
An old beau of mine.
The one that gave you those white box pieces? Oh,
yes, Mr. Shep Hundley. I hadn't seen him, and then last winter I ran into him on Biscayne Boulevard. And then just now, a wire invited me to a cruise of the Caribbean. The problem is clothes. I tore it in my trunk to see what I have that's suitable for the tropics.
They came up with that gorgeous diamond tiara?
Oh, this old relic, it's only rhinestones.
Gosh, I thought it was Tiffany's diamonds.
Well, anyhow, I shall be entertained in style.
Just goes to show you never know what's coming.
Oh, just when I thought my luck had begun to fail me.
Into the picture pops this Miami millionaire.
This man is not from Miami, this man is from Dallas.
This man is from Dallas?
Yes, where gold spouts out of the ground.
Just so he's from somewhere.
Close that curtain before you undress any further.
That's all I'm gonna undress for now. Have you seen the bottle opener? I used to have this cousin who would open bottles with his teeth. That's all he could do, his only accomplishment. He was a human bottle opener. And this one time at a wedding party, he broke his front teeth off. After that, he was so ashamed he used to sneak out of the house whenever company came. Oh, rain from heaven! What do you say, Blanche? Why don't we bury the hatchet and make it a lover cup?
No, thank you.
What are you putting on here?
What are you doing in here?
I'm gonna bring something out I only wear on special occasions. The silk pajamas I wore on my honeymoon. And then when the phone rings and they say you got a son, I'll pull them off and wave them over my head like a flag. I guess we both got an excuse for putting on the dog. You for having a millionaire, and me for having a baby.
Oh, when I think of how divine it is going to be to have such a thing as privacy once more, I could weep with joy.
This millionaire from Dallas is not gonna interfere with your privacy then?
It won't be the sort of thing that you have in mind. This man is a gentleman and he respects me. What he wants is my companionship. Sometimes having great wealth makes people lonely. And a cultivated woman, a woman of intelligence and breeding, can enrich a man's life immeasurably. And I have all those things to offer, and time doesn't take them away. Physical beauty is passing, a transitory possession, but beauty of the mind, richness of the spirit, and tenderness of the heart. And I have all those things. Do not fade, but increase with the years. Grow. How strange that I should be called a destitute woman when I have all of these treasures locked in my heart. But I've been foolish. Casting my pearls before...
Swine, huh?
Yes. Swine. Swine. And I'm speaking not only of you, but of your friend, Mr. Mitchell. He came here to see me tonight. He dared come here in his work clothes and repeat slander to me, vicious stories that he'd gotten from you. I gave him his walking papers.
That's so?
Yes, but then he came back with a box of roses to beg my forgiveness. He implored my forgiveness, but some things are not forgivable. Deliberate cruelty is not forgivable. It is the one unforgivable thing, in my opinion, and it is the one thing of which I have never, never been guilty. So I said to him, I said, it was foolish of me to think that we could ever adapt ourselves to each other. Our ways of life are too different. Our attitudes and our backgrounds are incompatible, so farewell, my friend, and let there be no hard feeling.
And was this before or after the wire came?
Why? Oh, after. As a matter of fact, the wire...
Yeah, as a matter of fact, there was no wire. There's no millionaire. He didn't come back with no flowers either, because I know where he was. It's not a damn thing but imagination and lies and conceit and tricks. And look at yourself. Look at this worn-out Mardi Gras dress, ready for some rag picker for 50 cents. And that crazy crown you got on. Now, what kind of queen do you think you are? I've been on you from the start. You never once pulled the wool over this boy's eyes. You come in here and you sprinkle your powder and you spray your perfume and you hang your paper lantern and lo and behold, it's Egypt and you're queen of the Nile. Sitting on your throne, swilling down my liquor. Well, I say ha ha. You hear me? Ha ha ha.
Baby,
what
are
Western Union. Western Union. Union, yes. I need to take down a message in desperate situation. In desperate situation, well, it's... No, I'm caught in a trap. Caught in a trap. Caught...
What's the phone after?
Let me get out. I want to get by you.
You want to get by you? Sure. Well, go right ahead.
You stand over there.
You got plenty of room to walk by me now. Think I'm gonna interfere with you? To think of it, maybe you wouldn't be so bad to interfere with.
Don't take another step toward me or I'll...
What?
Something awful will happen, it will.
What are you putting on here?
I'm in danger!
What'd you do that for?
So I could twist a broken end in your face?
I bet you would do that.
I would. I will!
Oh, you want some rough house? Let's have some rough house! Tiger, tiger! Drop that bottle top, drop it! You gotta believe you're lucky. Take it, Salerno. I believed I was lucky. I figured 4 out of 5 would come back, or wouldn't come back, and I'd be one of them. And I was. I put that down as a rule. To come ahead in this rat race of life, you gotta believe you're lucky.
You brag? You brag, that's bull. It's bull.
What's the matter with him?
Well, all is said, men were callous, unfeeling things, but it's just about all takes all. Pigs of yours.
What's the matter with her? Hey, come on, let's play.
How's my baby? Is he demanding his supper?
Oh, he's sleeping like an angel. Brought you some grapes.
Bless him, I just ate when I'm not in the same room with him.
Well, best leave him be till you know who gets settled. Where is she?
She's in the bathroom.
How is she?
She wouldn't take supper, but she did ask for a drink.
What'd you tell her?
We had made arrangements for her to rest in the country for a little while, and she's got it all mixed up in her head with Chef Hunley.
So?
Yes, Madge.
If I get a phone call on in the bathroom, will you tell them I'll call when I get out?
Yes.
And so?
Yes.
That cool yellow silk that you say? See, it's crushed. If it's not too crushed, I'll wear it in all the lapel, that silver and turquoise pin in the shape of a seahorse. You'll find that in the heart-shaped box where I keep my accessories. And so? See if you can locate that bunch of artificial violets in a box as well as a pin with a seahorse on the lapel of the jacket.
I'm just not sure that I've done the right thing.
Oh, what else could you do?
I couldn't believe her story. I'd go on living with Stanley.
Oh, you don't ever believe it. No matter what happens, honey, you gotta go on. We all gotta keep going on.
Stella?
Yes?
Is the coast clear? Is it safe? Oh, how many times until you close that curtain?
Hey, Mitch.
I just washed and fixed my hair. I don't know if I got all the stuff out.
Oh, but it's such fine hair.
It's a problem. Didn't I get a call? From who?
From
Chef Hunley.
No.
Georgia.
Mitch.
What's going on around here?
Not that.
I want an explanation of what's going on around here.
Hush.
Why are you two looking at me like that? Is there something wrong with me?
Oh, no, Mitch. No, no. You look wonderful. Doesn't she look wonderful?
Yes.
Oh, and Blanche, I understand you're going on a trip.
Yes, Blanche is going on a vacation.
Oh, I'm so green with envy.
Help me, you two. Help me get dressed.
That's what you want?
That'll do. I'm anxious to get out of here. This place is a trap.
What a pretty peach color.
Blush color.
Oh, I'm such colorblind as a bat.
Are those grapes washed?
Well,
those grapes, are they washed?
Well, they're from the French market.
That doesn't mean they've been washed. Those cathedral bells. They're the only clean thing in the quarter. Well, I'm ready to go now.
She's gonna leave before they get here.
Oh, well, I don't want to go in that room.
Well, stay here until the game breaks up.
I can smell the sea air. My element is the earth, but it should have been the water. Water, the blessedest thing that God created in those 7 days. The rest of my days I'm going to spend on the sea. And when I shall die on the sea. Do you know what I shall die of? I shall die of eating an unwashed grape. I shall die with my hand in the hand of some nice-looking ship's doctor, a very young one with a small blonde mustache and a big silver watch. Poor lady, they'll say, the quinine did no good. That unwashed grape has transported his soul to heaven. And then I'll be buried at sea, sewn up in a clean white sack and dropped overboard at noon in a blaze of summer and into an ocean as blue of my first lover's eyes.
I think they're here.
Doctor.
Yes.
I'll go see who's at the door.
I need the doctor's here.
Blanche, you have a visitor.
Is it the gentleman I was expecting?
I think it is.
I'm not ready yet.
Well, time to wait on the couch.
My mess of toilet articles are still out.
Come out.
They're waiting on the porch, Blanche.
They? Who's they?
Well, there's a lady with them.
I wonder who this lady could be. How is she dressed?
I was just in a plain tailored outfit.
Possibly. Are you ready to go? Yes. I don't want to pass in front of those men.
I will go with you.
How do I look?
Lovely.
Don't get up. I'm only passing through. You are not the gentleman I was expecting. That man is not Chef Huntley.
Blanche, you forget something?
Yes, I forgot something.
Oh, Blanche.
Yeah, she said she forgot something.
That's all right.
What'd you forget, Blanche?
It don't matter. We'll come back and pick it up later.
Yeah, we can send it along with your trunk.
I don't know you. I don't know you. Please, I want to be left alone, please.
Now, Blanche.
Now, Blanche, you didn't leave nothing here but some spilled talcum and empty perfume box. That's just the paper lantern you want. You want to take the lantern with you?
Check it, doctor!
Not unless necessary. Mr. Bois.
Please.
It won't be necessary.
Ask her to let go of me.
Yes. Let her go.
Whoever you are, I have always depended on the kindness of strangers.
But,
All right, boys. Let the cards set.
If